couple things before we fire this thing up. Number one, when you're going to fill it with oil, just don't assume that it's going to take the whole, I think it's a little less than 3/4 of a quart, because it's not. I almost made a mess of myself. And thank God that I had a rag underneath in case, because it did get overfilled. So I don't know, we'll have to see. It doesn't, I'm not going to say it hasn't met my expectations, because we haven't even fired it up, but just a lot of little things that you can tell it's not, you know, it's not real high quality, which I don't expect it. You pay for what you get, but you can see there's already erosion or rust. You can see right there. I mean, this is a brand new unit, you know. I don't think you should have that kind of shit on there. But again, that's me. Let's fire her up. Got the gas from to the on position. Battery's on. Let's give her a whirl. Efficiency mode. It's definitely, I would say it's definitely louder than the Predator. Trying to face it out. Idling smooth. See, I guess the battery switch has to be turned on. I mean, I haven't gone through the owner's manual. I've had fucking 100 of these things. So, but you can see this battery has to be on in order for you to shut the unit off itself. We're gonna try to fire up right now, see what she does. Hopefully she fires right back up. Haven't even tried to That worked. Let's try the start button now. Let her run for 2 hours and then change the oil on her. So far, so good. Not put any load or anything on. I will have to say this, though. I hate to say it, the Predator is, I mean, it's assembled better. It's put together better. I mean, this has got nicks and scratches and imperfections and shit. The other one didn't. We'll just have to see how well it handles. Let it run here for 2 hours and drain the oil, see what the oil looks like. And I'll have a video of that. Alrighty, guys.